In this video, we're going to be taking a look at chapter 12.4, additional angle measures and segment lengths. So there are three things that we need to remember. I think it's three, maybe four. I don't know. I can't remember. But the first is how do you find arc lengths and angle measures of lines intersecting in a circle? So if you take a look at this first picture here, I have lines intersecting inside a circle, a red line and a green line. They've got an intersection point inside the circle. If I want to find out the measure of angle one, all I have to do is take half of the sum of the two arc lengths. So I take half of arc length here and half of this arc length, add them together, and I'm done. Okay? So half of the sum of the intercepted arc lengths. All right, so how about if you have two lines that intersect outside of a circle? The formula is just a little bit different, okay? So I want to highlight, in the first one, we have an addition sign. In the second one, we have two intercepted arcs, right? One has a degree of x degrees, the other one is y degrees, and these arcs go from here to here and from here to here. All right, that's x degrees and y degrees. I want you to notice the difference in the formula. It is a subtraction. So I have an arc here and an arc here, an arc here, and an arc there. All right, we take those two arc measures, the big one minus the small one, and then multiply by a half. And that's different than the first one. We take the two arc measures and add them, then multiply by a half. So then I have segment products inside or outside a circle. So I have two lines, and if I'm not looking for angles, but I'm looking for segment lengths, regardless of whether they intersect inside or outside of a circle, all the formulas are right here. Okay, so if they intersect inside a circle, I take the two parts for each segment, right? When we have two intersecting lines, the lines cut each other into two parts. They may not be equal, but there's two parts. So I'm going to take A times B, right? I'm just going to multiply the two parts of each line and set them equal. So A times B equals C times D. Well, how do I do that if they intersect outside of a circle? Well, it's the part outside of the circle, right? The part outside of the circle times the entire length. Okay, so the part outside, which is W, times the entire length, which is x plus w. Okay, and that's going to equal the same thing. The part outside of the circle times the entire length. Part outside times the entire length. And that's even true if one of them is a tangent, right? I can think of it as the part outside times the entire length. Okay, so the part outside and the entire length are the same thing, so I get x squared. Here again, it's the part outside times the entire length, so it's y times y plus z, the entire length. All right, so we're going to use those formulas and we're going to work through some problems here. All right, so for the first one, we have two intersecting lines, and I want to point out that they intersect outside the circle. Because they intersect outside the circle, we will be using the formula for intersecting lines outside of the circles, the subtraction. So we have 1 half times x degrees minus y degrees. Okay, so what is x and y? Well, x is the larger arc. All right, these two lines intersect the circle here, here, and here. We have these two arcs, this arc here and this arc here, that we need to know the measure of. So when we find x degrees, right, we're going to say in hours, this is x equals 1 half The large arc in green, which is 160 degrees, minus the small arc in yellow, which is 68 degrees. And when I do that calculation, I get 1/2 of 160 minus 68 is 92 degrees, and that was supposed to be half, not 1/9. All right, and then what's a half of 92 degrees? Well, that is 46 degrees. So that angle measure formed by those two lines has an angle of 46 degrees. All right, so how do we do this one? Again, I want to point out that these two lines intersect outside of the circle. So again, we're going to use this formula, the subtraction formula. So I need my two arc measures. Well, the small one, it's clear what the small one is. That's 120. But the big one is the rest of the circle. And I know in a circle I have 360 degrees. So this big one is 360 minus 120. So it's 240 degrees. So now I'm going to just use those two arc measures to find x. So it's 1/2 times the big arc, the green arc, minus the small arc. So I get 1/2 of 120 degrees. So x is going to be 60 degrees. All right, so how do we do the next one? Well, this one is interesting. So what I think I'm going to do first is I'm going to find my arc measure, because my arc measure is equal to, this is a regular polygon, okay? If their arcs are all the same, right? There are little tick marks around telling me that all the arcs are the same. That means their central angle, the arc, the angle of the central angle of the arc are all congruent, which tells me I have a regular polygon. So if all of these angles are congruent, I have five angles that make up 360 degrees. So what is 360 divided by 5? 360 over 5, well, I know that's going to be 72 degrees. So if this is 72 degrees, then the measure of my arc is 72 degrees. So that's x. So now we're going to go, and we're going to go back to section, I think, 12.3. And I want you to remember in 12.3, let's take a look at this. We have a nice tangent line here. And we have a chord here. Okay, a nice chord. And we want to find the measure of this angle here because they're asking us for y. So if you remember, the measure of a tangent to a circle and a chord, that angle between, is half of the intercepted arc length. We just found that the arc length for all of these arcs is 72 degrees. So when I solve for y is going to be 1/2 of the arc measure. So I get a nice 36 degrees for y. All right, so now let's move on to this crazy looking problem here. Well, this one isn't too bad because I have a, I'm gonna look for x first. I have a nice large arc here. Goes up to here. And then I have a smaller arc that goes here. Because remember, I have this angle intercepts my circle in three different places, so I look for the arcs there. All right, so when I'm going to find, I'm going to set up the equation. So this is, they intersect, my lines intersect outside of my circle. So to find the measure of x, I'm going to use this formula. Okay, so I know the measure of my angle. The measure of my angle equals this. So I know that 50 degrees is going to equal the big arc minus the small arc, 1/2, the green arc minus the small arc. Okay, so I'm gonna just multiply both sides by 2 to get rid of that fraction. I have 100 degrees equals 160 minus x degrees. I'll subtract 160 from both sides to get negative 60 equals negative x. So x is going to be 60 degrees. So if x is 60 degrees, if this arc is 60 degrees, what is this blue arc gonna be? Well, I know the complete circle, right? The green, the yellow, and the blue is a complete circle. So that's 360 degrees. So I know that 60 and 160 is 220. What would I have to add to 220 to get 360? So this blue arc is 360 degrees minus 220 degrees, which is gonna be 140 degrees. So that's gonna be 140 degrees. And remember going back a section, right? I have a tangent line and a nice chord. So this angle here is half of the intercepted arc. So y is half of the intercepted arc, and that intercepted arc is 140 degrees. So y is 70 degrees. Okay, so let's do this little ice cream cone looking problem. It's beautiful. All right, so it looks like this guy right here, I'm gonna draw it in blue, looks like this guy is a nice diameter, which tells me something about this big arc here. This guy, this total green arc is 180 degrees. All right, so because that is 180 degrees, the little arc here, all right, they tell us it's y. So where do all these points, they intercept these two arcs, the big green arc and the little yellow arc. And we have two lines that intersect outside of our circle. So again, we're gonna use the subtraction, the big arc minus the little arc. So we have the measure of our angle equals that. So we have 53 degrees is the measure of our angle. And that is going to equal 1/2 times the green arc, which is 180 degrees. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. 180 degrees minus the yellow arc, which is y degrees. So I'm just gonna multiply both sides by 2 to get rid of my fraction. So 106 degrees is 180 degrees minus y. So when I subtract 180 from both sides of this equation, I get, let's see, negative 74 degrees equals negative y. So y is going to equal 74 degrees. Okay. So now I think I forgot to put a variable in here. I need to find this as well. All right, so in order to find that, I have two lines. I'm gonna draw them with green and yellow. And their intersection point is inside the circle. So now's the time I'm gonna use the other. The measure of the angle equals 1/2. And I'm gonna add the two arc lengths instead of subtracting them. So what arc lengths do I need to add? I need to add this arc length, okay? Because when I look at the endpoints of my lines, these two endpoints make that arc, and this arc right here. So because this is a diameter, I know this big red arc is 180 degrees, but what is this small arc? Well, I had said before that the big green arc down here was 180 degrees. Well,